Welcome back. In this video, we will cover the basics of defining function parameters and understanding function arguments, as well as dive into some best practices and advanced topics to help you level up your JavaScript skills. First, let's start with the basics. A function is a block of code that performs a specific task. Function parameters are the variables that are defined inside the parentheses of the function definition. They are used to accept values that are passed into the function when it is called. On the other hand, function arguments are the actual values that are passed to the function when it is called. For example, let's create a simple function that takes two parameters and add them together. In this example, num1 and num2 are the function parameters, and they are used to accept values that will be passed to the function. The return keyword is used to return the sum of num1 and num2. Now let's see how we can define function parameters. Defining function parameter is done inside the parentheses of the function definition. We can define one or more parameters separated by commas. For example, let's create a function that takes three parameters, first name, last name, and age. In this example, we have defined three parameters, first name, last name, and age. When the greetUser function is called with values of these three parameters, it will log a greeting message to the console. Now let's move on to understanding function arguments. Function arguments are the actual values that are passed to the function when it is called. These values can be of any data type, such as numbers, strings, objects, or arrays. For example, let's call the greetUser function that we defined earlier with some arguments. In this example, John is passed as the first name argument, Doe is passed as the last name argument, and 30 is passed as the age argument. When this function is called with these arguments, it will log the message "Hello John Doe, you are 30 years old" to the console. Now let's talk about the best practices of working with function parameters and arguments. These practices are important to ensure that our code is easy to read, maintainable, and scalable. One of the best practices for working with function parameters is to use clear and concise naming conventions. We should use names that clearly indicate the purpose of the parameter. For example, if a function is calculating the area of rectangle, we could use length and width as parameter names instead of A and B. Another best practice is to avoid using too many parameters in a function. If a function has too many parameters, it can become difficult to understand and maintain. In these cases, we should consider grouping related parameters into objects or arrays. Lastly, we should try to keep our functions as pure as possible. This means that a function should not modify its parameter or have any side effects. Instead, a function should return a new value or object based on the parameter it receives. Now let's move on to the advanced topics in function parameters and arguments. These topics are more complex and require a deeper understanding of JavaScript functions. One advanced topic is callback functions. A callback function is a function that is passed as an argument to another function and is executed inside the function. Callback functions are commonly used in JavaScript for asynchronous programming, such as handling events or making HTTP requests. For example, let's say we have a function called fetchData that makes an HTTP request and receives data as a response. We can pass a callback function as an argument to this function to handle the data when it receives. Another advanced topic is higher order functions. A higher order function is a function that takes one or more functions as an argument or returns a function as it results. Higher order functions are useful for creating reusable code and for composing complex behaviors. For example, let's say we have a function called multiplyBy that takes a number and returns a new function that multiplies any input by that number. In this example, multiplyBy is a higher order function because it returns a new function as it results. And that's a wrap. We have covered a lot of ground on function parameters and arguments, from the basics to some more advanced topics. Remember to use clear naming conventions, avoid too many parameters, and keep your functions pure. With these best practices and advanced techniques, you will be well on your way to writing better and more efficient JavaScript code. Thanks for watching.